Hi, in this video I'm going to add some animations for the movement and a simple visual effect for dashing. Prior to the video I modeled and rigged a very basic character in Blender, but you can also use your own models or maybe even download one from Mixamo. When naming the animations I made sure to follow Godot's convention so I wouldn't have to readjust them once I imported the model. For instance, if you add a loop suffix to the animation's name in Blender, Godot will automatically set it to loop when importing. For all other options, you can check out the link in the description box below. To start off, I create a new folder called Models under the Assets folder and import the GLTF file into it. Once the model is imported, I double-click on the file and select New Inherited to create a Godot scene based on it. I rename the newly created scene in Pascal case as Player Doll and save it under the Player folder. In terms of animations, I have one called Crouch Idle Loop to use when the player is crouched and not moving, Crouch Walk Loop for when they are crouched and moving, Fall Loop for when they are falling, Fall to Land for when they are about to land, Idle Loop for when they are standing still, Idle to Jump for when they are jumping off, Run Loop for when they are running, and T-Pose Loop for the T-Pose, which is unused. In the player scene, I remove the capsule and cylinder mesh instances from the skin node and add the player doll instead. Godot and Blender use different directions of the Z-axis as default, so I rotate the doll, not the skin, in the Y-axis by 180 degrees. Next, to handle animation transitions, I add an animation tree under the skin and give it an empty blend tree as the tree root. To set the animation player, I first right-click on the player doll, check the editable children box, and then select this animation player node as the player. With that done, I set the animation tree as active and start building the transitions. I create three blend space 1Ds for each root state in my movement state machine, on ground, in air, and crouching. To transition between them, I add a transition node, set its input count to 3, rename the inputs as kebab case versions of each state, set the crossfade time to 0.2, connect the transition node to the output so its visuals get updated, and finally connect each blend space to the appropriate slots. For the on-ground state, I place the idle loop animation at 0 and the run loop animation at 0.3. This means that when I set the blend position to 0, the idle loop animation will be played. When I set it to 0.3 or beyond, the run loop animation will be played. And when I set it to a value between 0 and 0.3, a mix of both animations will be played. For the in-air state, I place the fall loop animation at 0, idle to jump at positive 0.3, and jump to fall at negative 0.3. If I change the transition node's current to in-air, you can see that the falling animation plays. And when I set it back to on-ground, it blends between the falling and standing animations. Also, if I change to in-air while its blend position is at 1, it plays the jump animation. Finally, for the crouching node, I add crouch loop at 0 and crouch walk loop at 0.3. Back in the player script, I get an already reference to the animation tree so I can use it in state scripts. To obtain the names of the animation tree parameters that you can change, you can select the animation tree node and look at the names of individual values in the parameters dropdown in the inspector. At this point, I realize that I haven't given a name to the transition node, so I rename it to root state. Then in the on-ground script, I add an enter method, and in it I set parameter slash root state slash current to 0, which is the 0-based order number of the on-ground input. Note that we can't use the names of the inputs here, but rather their order numbers. In the in-air and crouching state scripts, I make similar changes, but this time I use 1 and 2 as the values respectively. Next, I go back to the on-ground state script, add a physics process method, and in it I set parameter slash on-ground slash blend position to the length of the player's current velocity, divided by 10, which is the move speed. I also go into the running state script and make sure it calls the super implementation of its physics process, otherwise the one in the on-ground script will not be called, and the animation would not change. Similarly, in the physics process method of the in-air state script, I set the in-air blend position to the player's Y velocity, divided by 50, which is the max terminal velocity. As for crouching, I use the player's horizontal velocity again, but this time dividing its length by 4. And that's it. When I run the game now, you can see that all animations are played when I run, walk, jump, or fall, so the only thing I have to do now is to add a visual effect for the dash. For that, I add a particles node to the skin, adjust its size and positioning, and begin creating something that resembles a quick dash. As the first and only draw pass, I add a box shape with a size of 0.04 by 0.04 by 2. For the process material, I add a particles material, set its gravity to 0, its direction to 1 in the z-axis, its spread to 0, and its velocity to 1. I change the emission shape to box and change its extents to cover the player model. Next, I add a new spatial material as the material override in the geometry section, set it as transparent and unshaded, and I also enable the use as albedo flag so it uses whatever color I give it from the particles material. Next, I set the skull mode to disabled and blend mode to add. Back in the particles material, I set the color ramp to a gradient that moves from a gold yellow to a light yellow, and finally into an even lighter yellow with an alpha value of 0. Next, I give it a scale curve that gradually drops down to 0. And finally, in the time section, I set the lifetime to 0.3, amount to 16, explosiveness to 1, randomness to around 0.3, and enable one shot. To finish off, I name the particles node as VFX dash, get an already reference to it in the player script, and in the enter method of the dashing script, I set its emitting value to true. And now, whenever I dash, I leave some light streaks behind me. So that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. The animations and visual effects may not be perfect, but the implementation is there, and I can always polish later. As always, you can find links to the raw assets and the example project in the description box below. Thanks for watching.